Honda suggests that the vast majority of small dual-sport bikes spend much of their life on the pavement. And maybe that's true, they do make for fantastic daily commuters. That doesn't mean their riders don't still dream of big adventures and dusty trails, though. Dreams of rally flash through their mind at every glimpse over at rolling hills to nowhere, and we can't blame them for it. We all do it. There we are, standing on the pegs, a trailing backlit dust cloud shoved against a setting sun, all happening below a golden sky in some faraway land. That's the dream. And it's that sort of vision that comes to mind when you first look at Honda's newest on-road off-road offerings, the crf250l and crf250l rally. On board the rally, you even feel it. Updated for 2017, both crf250l models see the same handful of changes over the previous 250l. Most significant is a 2 mm increase in throttle body size from 36 mm to 38 mm, which comes as an attempt to improve throttle response and increase power in the low to mid RPM range. Honda claims a weight savings through the use of an exhaust with larger header pipe and lighter weight twin-chamber muffler. The airbox has been revised and new graphics have both machines matching their bigger siblings, the CRF450R and the Team HRC CRF450 rally bike. One look at the rally and you will notice the most obvious differences over the L, those being the Dakar rally-inspired bodywork and frame-mounted dash tower, with windscreen shape that's nearly identical to that of the Team Monster Energy Honda CRF450 rally bike. A creatively styled asymmetrical headlight, taller suspension, plastic skid plate, and standard black handguards round out the list of other significant differences over the standard model. There are less noticeable, but still very important, changes throughout. The 0.6-gallon larger, 2.7-gallon fuel tank and 40 mm larger front brake disc 296 mm versus 256 mm are a perfect example. Both motorcycles come standard with a non-adjustable inverted front fork and ProLink rear shock. The Rally is equipped with 30 mm longer fork, the front end offering up 11 inches of travel and the back a total of 10.3 inches. Compare that to the 250L, which offers up 9.8 inches and 9.4 inches respectively. This all adds up to a claimed 24 mm more ground clearance for the Rally. Greater fuel capacity and additional bodywork has the Rally weighing close to 25 pounds, more than the standard CRF250L 317 pounds, versus 341 pounds, for non-ABS versions. Meanwhile, peak power is around 24.4 horsepower. Thanks in part to its 0.8-inch taller seat height, the CRF250L Rally feels immediately more grown-up as you throw a leg over it, like an adventure bike but at a more manageable weight and size. The difference, of course, is that where those bikes have packed on the pounds with the growing demand of horsepower and various creature comforts like heated seats and built-in phone chargers, there are no such luxuries on this adventure seeker. There's a little extra weight over the standard L model, sure, but it feels negligible at best. What are the bikes like from in the saddle, or should we say up on the pegs, seeing as how that's where ya will be when you realize that the biggest downside for smaller dual-sport bikes isn't the lack of ponies, but the elongated reach down to the handlebar. Well, admittedly, the standard CRF250L still gets to feeling on the small side when tarmac turns to terra firma. On the other hand, with its taller suspension and tall dash tower, the Rally has an improved posture. When standing on the pegs, fully up and out of the saddle, it feels like a natural off-road motorcycle. Our ride day was split into two routes, one for the Rally and another for the L, with a lunch stop in between. For the first part of the day I was on board the Rally, tackling pavement, and then ducking off toward a medium-paced dirt road scattered with rain bars. There, I learned how easy it is to override the suspension. But while bottoming out at either end was a reminder that this was not a rally bike or even a bike intended to be ridden in anger, it was only a momentary setback to the good times. I found a pace that the Rally was happy with by rolling out of the throttle a bit. Wide gear ratios between first, second and second, third kept me busy, and I was still hunting pretty feverishly for proper revs, but find the right good gear and it was nothing but good times. Some sections of the trail required fanning the clutch like I was on a two-stroke, but other, mellower sections were fine. The wide bodywork and the Dakar-style windshield tower are not just cool-looking, but actually provide more wind protection than the sleek design would suggest. This even at speeds greater than 70 miles per hour. Unfortunately, the CRF250L's optional ABS WASNT is friendly, especially in off-road riding situations. The system can be switched off at the rear wheel, but stays engaged at the front wheel. The system has its benefits on pavement, but I still feel that, in the dirt, an experienced off-road rider will find it a little unnerving. The ability to switch the system off at both the front and rear would be an improvement, in my opinion. As for the L, I'd say that if going off-road is not fully your thing, then the bike will suit your needs just fine. A 10-mile section of tight, twisting road that we ran was a combination of broken asphalt, with some corners lightly dusted with sand and gravel. In this type of riding, the L was quite impressive. More power would have been appreciated, but this is a 250cc single after all. Keep that in mind and you will be plenty happy. Handling was quite good, too. I could have ridden that section over and over again, and enjoyed every last minute of it. So what's the verdict? Both bikes are a true bargain for fun seekers. They provide a smooth, comfortable all-day riding experience and terrific fuel economy for your daily commute. The crf250l has a very attractive $5,149 point of entry, but I'm a daydreamer trying to keep that Dakar fantasy alive. I would spend the extra $750 for the rally and all its added features but opt out of the abs. Regardless of which side of the gravel road you might fall on, the reality is that these are two great options for the dreamer in search of a big adventure, on the budget of the typical weekend warrior. CRF250L specs: engine type, displacement, bore stroke, seat height, rake, trail wheelbase, fuel capacity, claimed curb weight, price. CRF250L rally specs: engine type, displacement, bore stroke, seat height, rake, trail wheelbase, fuel capacity, claimed curb weight, price.